I wonder sometimes if there is any YouTuber content creator more inconsistent than I am, because I highly doubt it. I am lucky enough to get out one video a month on this channel. Since I've got you here, let me say welcome to Easily Influenced. My name's Christy. This is actually my second channel. I am around more frequently over on the other one, and it's going to be about keto, low carb, weight loss, recipes, grocery hauls. So if you want to follow me over there, I'll put it down in the description box. I started this channel because I wanted to have fun. I wanted to try all of the trends, try the new products, bring them to you, review things, hence the name Easily Influenced. If it's on social media, if it's on TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, if it's hit it big, I want to be able to talk about it with you guys. Today, we're going to be talking about one of the hottest new trends on all social media platforms. The weight loss gurus, dietitians, doctors on TikTok. Every single platform has been bombarded. And no, I'm not talking about cottage cheese. That's on my other channel. We're talking about continuous glucose monitors. We're going to explore the Freestyle Libre 3. Why is everyone obsessed with it? Why does everybody feel like they need one? Are they worth the hype? How amazing are they? Do they hurt? What do they do? And most importantly, I'm going to tell you something you probably do not know about the Freestyle Libre continuous glucose monitor. And it's very important. When I started this video, like 5 minutes ago, the sun was out and it was a gorgeous day. Now there's a storm a-brewing. It looks like it is 8 o'clock at night. And for some reason, the cicadas in the background, well, anytime it starts to get dark around here, even if it is just from a storm a-brewing, those things start singing. So I apologize. Unless you like to hear cicadas, then you're welcome. That's what I'm talking about. I noticed the trend around continuous glucose monitors about a year ago, but that's because I have a special interest in these beauties. We will discuss that later. YouTubers, content creators, normal everyday people are testing their reaction to foods and activities. What happens if I eat McDonald's? Do you really need a glucose monitor for that? Don't think so. Doctors over here on these platforms are even telling you how to get one of these if your doctor won't give you a prescription. The Freestyle Libre 3 by Abbott. It is their newest model. It was released this past October. The sensor is about the size of 2 stacked pennies. They were initially created for type 1 diabetics to better control blood sugar levels, to know exactly what to give themselves as far as insulin. And now they pair with insulin pumps. They work in tandem, so you're not constantly injecting yourself with insulin. They work as a team. You put this in whichever designated area you want it on your body. They give you examples in the little booklet that's in here. When it's on, it's going to stay on for 2 weeks before it needs to be replaced, and it gives up to the minute glucose readings. Now those readings will be sent to the app if you download it onto your phone, or you can pick up the little monitor that you carry around. She's about $100, and you have to have a doctor's prescription to be able to get one of these at your pharmacy. If you have to replace it every 2 weeks, obviously you're going to need 2 a month. So approximately $200. If you do get the prescription for it and you can get the clearance from your insurance company, for me, I pay $30 for 2, so $15 each. Let's open it up and I'll show you what it looks like in the process of putting one on. Everything is right here, all one piece. Choose the site where you want to put the sensor. I like going with the sides of my arm and towards the back of my arm because it's convenient. I can reach it really easy and I don't have to worry about knocking it up against something and maybe it coming off. Clean the site with an alcohol pad and give it time to dry. Twist it off. Your little sensor that is going to attach to the site is going to be right here. And like I said, it's about the size of two stacked pennies. So it's small. Place it where you want the sensor to be attached. Push down. It automatically ejects the little needle that threads the sensor right under the skin onto your arm. Automatically sticks. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. There you go. That's it. And no, it does not hurt at all. Using the little handheld monitor or the app on your phone, you're going to hold it up to the sensor. Then it's going to start the countdown. For the Libre 3, it takes 60 minutes before you will get your first reading. These units are not testing blood. They're testing the fluid that's right under the skin. So they're not as accurate as a blood glucose stick on your finger, but it tests it, and each minute it updates the number that's on the app or the monitor so you know exactly where your glucose levels are. Tip, sometimes these bad boys, they just don't work correctly. Keep the box and that system until you're done with it at the 2-week mark, then you can recycle it or whatever you need to. But if you keep this unit and then for some reason it fails, you can get a hold of the company and they'll send you a new one. Let's talk about the app on my phone, because this is how I do everything. I don't want to carry a monitor around plus my phone. I just have it all right here. Yeah, I'm a little high right now. My glucose is high. I mean, in the app, I have access and ability to do all of these things. First of all, I have a graph and the number. Alarms, daily patterns, times in range, low glucose event, average glucose. This will even give me an A1C over the past 3 months. Sensor usage, and over here, add notes. So if you take insulin, you can log that. If you have so many carbs at a meal, lots of features. Ooh, I got the up arrow. See, it's telling me that I'm trending up. I had a piece of mango. You can set reminders. So if you got to take your medicines, it will let you know. You can connect this with your healthcare provider and it will send them your numbers, your information, so that it's going to help them with your medical care. The alarm on this particular system can be set and changed if you want to be alerted when your blood glucose goes over a specific number. It's going to send out this high-pitched noise, and if you go below a certain number, it's going to send that out as well. Truthfully, those are features that someone who has no health condition, no medical need for a unit like this really needs. Nobody really needs those alarms, except for if you have a medical condition. Those are life-saving alarms. I have a medical need or the Freestyle Libre 3. I am, unfortunately, a type 1 diabetic. I'm not happy about it. I was diagnosed about 2 years ago. That's right. In my late 40s, with no family history, I became a type 1 diabetic. Fortunately for me, I was already doing a low-carb lifestyle. When I got the diagnosis, I was handed two prescriptions, actually three. One for insulin, one for a CGM, and one for a glucagon pen in case I had a blood glucose low and I became unconscious, unresponsive. I couldn't eat or drink something with sugar to bring the glucose up. That injection would do it, hopefully. Literally terrified to put this on in the beginning. I thought it was going to hurt. It didn't. Poking my finger continually to check my numbers to see where I was at, to know exactly how much insulin I needed throughout the day. That hurts a lot worse than this one stick. Do I think these things are amazing? Heck yeah, I do. The feature that I love most is the fact that it has that alarm on it. So when my blood sugar gets to a specific number, which is really low, and I could possibly go unconscious, be unresponsive, it sends out this high-pitched, blaring alarm to me and also to my family members that have downloaded the app onto their phones. That way, they know, come check on me and possibly even call 911. Because 4 weeks ago, that's exactly what happened. My blood sugar dropped so quickly out of nowhere that I was unresponsive for 3 hours. And that's one of those situations where if left untreated can cause death. The alarms on this saved me. I was doing low carb keto way before I was a type 1 diabetic and had lost about 70 pounds. Did I wear a continuous blood glucose monitor? Nope. Was I checking my blood sugar levels to see how foods and even activities affected me? Yep. Because I was recording all of that and I was putting it on my other channel, Christy Davis, link below, and I was sharing it with hundreds of thousands of you guys. But guess what? I was doing a finger stick because it's more accurate and those blood glucose systems where you prick your little finger and then put that little blood in there and it sucks it up and gives you a number, those are much more readily available than these. Because guess what? There's something that no one's telling you, no one's talking about, but it is fact. There's a shortage. And the people that need them most, like type 1 diabetics, adults, and children, people with hypoglycemia, gestational diabetes, type 2 diabetes, are having a hard time getting these because everybody wants to play with them. I even read an announcement where this company recently partnered up with, I think, NOM, N-O-O-M, and Weight Watchers, and I think a few others, so that when you join that diet program, you will be able to have access to the Freestyle Libre 3 that I can't even get. This makes my already miserable condition, type 1 diabetes, a little bit more bearable and a little bit more easy to control, but yet I can't get them. So let me finish up by saying, I think they're awesome. Absolutely amazing. I think in the future, everybody should have one and try one. But for now, and until there is no longer a shortage, maybe you should not get one like the Freestyle Libre or the Dexcom. Leave those for the people that have medical need, like life and death situations. I'm sure there's parents out there that need this for their children that are diabetics, and it gives them peace of mind to be able to look at their phone and see at 3 a.m. what their child's blood sugar is so that they can help control that better, because you know a four-year-old can't. Do you need a CGM? I don't know. Do you? Just do your research. Make sure you're not getting one that is taking away from someone else right now until the shortages are over, and then you can stock up on these if you want to. Right now, every single month, I get that phone call that they're out of stock. I'm having a hard time getting them. I know other people are as well. If you don't care, share this video, like it, comment. Let's send it out to as many people as possible, because I am sure the majority of these people that are picking these up probably have no idea that they are getting a monitor that someone needs to have a better quality of life or possibly even survive. So let's let them all know. Share it if you don't care. Thanks for hanging out with me this really dreary, nasty day. If you've not subscribed, I'd love to have you here and on my other channel. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.